Hello everybody and welcome on board this 737-800. It's going to run through the start procedures quickly just to show you guys what it's all about. Firstly, we're going to make sure that the park brake is set and the engine start levers are cut off. And then from there on, we'll turn on the battery. I've reviewed the books already to make sure everything's good. So well, there's the battery switch, put that to on. And then we have a look when we have some power at what our battery voltage is. From there, we go down and we do the fire test. Then we check the squibs, which is the sort of explosive charges that are fitted to the fire bottles, two for the engines, one for the APU. And then we carry on with the fault testing of the actual fire rooms, as well as that. And see that our fire lights come on. From there, the next step is to start the APU. Little lever over there, momentary on. You'll see a little flick in the actual temperature gauge over there, marked in EGT, engine gas temperature. From there we should have the oil low pressure light come on, just as a test. This should go out eventually, as soon as we sort of turn enough RPM to turn the oil pump. There she goes. Now we're waiting for this light to come on, which is the APU, really light. These two are for the engine generators, this one is for the APU. And there we go, it's on. And from there we select the APU generator to on. Power both sides. Ah, some air coming through. When we move on to the overhead panel further, you'll see the visualization panel. It's got the APU bleed switch here, which we need for engine starting and APU. Air for bleed, air for air conditioning. See the bleed pressure gauge rise, showing us pressure on both sides. From there we can turn the air conditioning packs on. Give us some cool air. We'll also get a dual bleed indicator light because we have air supplied from the APU. And it's thinking it's from the engine side as well, so you have the dual bleed light. Temperature selector knobs, and there's the stall warning test and airspeed test, the clickers and clackers. Can't do that now, it's too noisy. Here we have the oxygen, and we go down to the window gates for the four forward windows on, and then do the overheat test. That's all normal. Select off. From there we go down there, wing anti-ice. And we have the electric hydraulic pumps, which we need to turn them on. As you go down, you should see our brake pressure gauge go up to 3,000 psi. Carry on further with the emergency lights to arm. Just flick the little toggle. That's a normal, that's normal, that's normal. But they're not bright, it's just the overhead lights. Here we get our inertial reference system. IRSs, we turn it to align and then wait for the two battery indicators to come on, and then we select over to nav and the alignment will start. This will take about 6 or 7 minutes. It's indicated by that little LED display there, liquid crystal. And back over to our electrics panel, and here we have our cabin utilities, which is the seat power and the galley power, or IV, the two of them. And then we go over to the fuel pumps, six of them, two in the wings, two in the other wing, two in the center. The one on the left hand side is on to supply us fuel to the APU while they're running it. And then we can select the yaw damper on over here, and that should go out. From there, it's on normal up to the flap slack indicator lights. centimetres. So that concludes the overhead panel. From there we come down, we just cancel all this lights over here in the six pack. We carry on with our pre-flight. We can cage this, just to upright it. Little standby horizon. Here we can check the auto brake system. This should go on and then off. That's perfect. We can check the landing gear lighting. See, that works perfectly. We can also do a ground control test.
Light slope. Pull up.
All of those things come up.
Wind shear. Wind shear. Wind shear. Terrain. Terrain. Pull up. Airspeed low.
And that's a little test of the radar.
Pull up. Terrain. Pull up. Don't sink. Don't sink. Too low. Terrain. Too low. Gear. Too low. Flaps. Too low. Terrain. Glide slope. Bank angle. Bank angle.
Approaching minimums. Minimums. 2,500. 1,000. 500. 400. 300. 200. 100. 50. 40. 30. 20. 10.
Wind shear. Wind shear. Wind shear. Too low. Terrain. Caution. Terrain. Caution. Terrain. 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 Pull up.
Right, now that's done. We go over and select this onto MFC, our management controller. There we go. We select the line towards the GPS. Which we are setting above here. Right. Push the wrong button there. From there we go back to our reference page, because we did the iris on over here. We were waiting for them to carry on for 3 more minutes. And we go down here and we give the iris position. There. And now it's selected. That is our position for the aircraft vehicle for now. After that iris is over line, 2 minutes to go, our instrumentation will come alive. From here we continue down the center panel, check the speed brake, which is over there. We should have the arm lights come on over there. Put that out of the way. Check the throttles and the warnings. And we can go over here and test the trim motors, since we still have that running strip on. Adjusting the trim motors, you'll see the wheels turn. Adjust the stabilizer trim at the bottom. And take off this morning, we'll be in the green band in the range there. You'll see the little needle move over the trims up. Fire test we've done. Now we can test the cargo fire system. And then on the radios we can select the ATIS.
Clouds scattered at 1,200 feet, broken at 2,500 feet.
ATIS is 127.
2.18. 1009er.
Ah. Noted.
Confirm Cape Town International Air.
Now that we have that, we can go over here and adjust Q&H. Let's go there. So now we can active that side as well. hydraulic pedals. And now with the IRA system being alive, or active, as you see over there, you'll see the instruments came alive, so these are weather over pattern. And that concludes the B-flight. I'm sure there are more to check, but I'm not giving everything right now. Good day.